Hey all, Penguin Propaganda here. Just wanted to give you a quick intro into the video that you're about to see. This is just straight gameplay of Baldur's Gate 3, day one, using Linux Proton. A couple of things I'd like you to know. One, I'll give you the system specs. AMD 5950X, 128 gigs of RAM, GeForce 3070, 8 gigabyte. Okay, it's running Arch Linux, and it was updated last week, so pretty much latest stuff. We're running on, obviously, Steam, Proton, and literally just downloaded the game and bought it today. This video will be just me playing through, no voiceover, no commentary, no nothing. There'll be some chapters at the bottom there. Maybe you want to skip over the character selection, or you want to skip over some of the cinematics or something. A couple other things you should know about how I'm doing this. One, I've never played this game before, so I did a lot of stupid stuff. I didn't know how to cast spells at the beginning, so I screwed that up a little bit and some other things. It's fine. It's just what it is. I had no idea what I was doing at all, and I've not watched one video about how this game works, so you should know that. A couple things about the install and the setup. One, you have the Larian installer, so some of that section will be kind of blurred out, so some of that personal info is not there. And I'll also have a blur over the nudity. I have it all enabled. I wanted to see all the options. I wanted to see what kind of weird stuff they gave you. But just a heads up, the nudity will be blurred out so that if kids run across this video, they're not going to see the wee-wees and the vajayjays and all of that. Other than that, it's just the game being run, and you can see how it works. The final thing to know is that this very first playthrough did not save. And there is a bug known with this where you cannot save if you have the cross-platform save enabled, which I just happened to turn on. I didn't really know what it was. I just figured, what the hell, we'll turn it on and see how it works. But what happens is it just cycles and never can sync with the Larian server. And so you just lose, like nothing can save. You can turn that off. You just turn off the cross-platform save option, and then you have to exit out of the game and get back into it, because if you don't exit out, it for some reason doesn't reset. Then it'll start saving the game fine. I did test that earlier today, and it worked okay. But I will show you right here. And that's how you do it. So you just turn it off. Anything else? If you have questions, you want to make fun of me, you want to have fun, you're concerned about some weird glitch that you noticed that I didn't see, hey, feel free to leave a comment, and we'll get back with you. All right, thanks. Have a good day.
quiet stranger. You find yourself in the presence of the renowned wizarding prodigy, Gale of Waterdeep. Please, no need to be intimidated. My virtuosic talents once caught the eye of the goddess of magic herself, Mistra, who named me her chosen and her lover. Thanks to a slight miscalculation on my part, that relationship eventually soured, as did the greatest of my powers. Now I'm merely a humble wizard on the road to redemption. Unless I can find the path to something greater. Thank you.
Where to next?
Let's hope the locals are...
Health.
Be wary. This place is trapped.
It's opened.
More of those wretched things.
There's magic keeping this chest.
Where to next?
What was that?
Let's hope the locals are friendly.
Health.
Be wary. This place is trapped.
Opened.
More of those wretched things.
parasite now writhing behind your eye.
To save us from this place. From this place, you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return! They return. enemy. So many enemies. A newborn. Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer. A minion of the mind flayers who abducted you. Making it more subservient, should it prove a threat. Of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind. Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind. Thank you. past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flesh face seen through the screen of his eyes.
What is this?
Be true.
The mechanisms are completely unrecognizable at first. Then you spy an empty socket.
Whatever fits in that socket must be...
Light flickers in his eyes, but he seems totally unaware of his surroundings. The device betrays its purpose. It could do anything. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. The parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority.
I thought that damn thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness, because you have a gift with you.
You keep dangerous company. Fair point. Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way.
To get to the helm now.
She's right. Lead on. Nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say. Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment. Kanyank. Thank you.
beast woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you. Dazed woman is trapped inside the pod. As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod, commanding the person inside to change.
taking position.
Just so. The helm's alien transmission. As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. Other than the infection, you're more or less intact. A miracle, given everything you've been through. But it'll all be for nothing if you don't find help soon. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking. You need a cure.